I'm going to try to give some tips to some of you guys that may have questions about creating a flight plan in FSX. So first thing you need to do is bring up the game, and this is the screen that you'll have. Be sure and click on Free Flight, and then you will want to go to the current aircraft and change it. So go ahead and click on Change. And this will bring up a window showing all your aircraft that you have loaded by default. And if you have added any aircraft, it will show them as long as you have a check mark where it says Show All Variations. So make sure you check that. Now I've got some a lot of different textures for some 737-800s. Just click on one, and to bring it up real quick, hit details, and that brings the picture up a lot faster than just clicking OK. Use the wheel on your mouse to scroll in and out. You can left click and hold it, and you can drag it around, rotate it. That's not the one you want. Just click cancel, click on another one, hit details, zoom it in, left click and hold, rotate. If that's not the one you want, just cancel it. We'll go ahead and pick the 737-800 DHL 737, and we'll just go ahead and click OK. And that brings it up in this window, and you can still zoom in with the wheel on your mouse or out. Left click and hold to rotate it. Okay. Now we're going to be creating a flight plan, so go ahead and click on Flight Planner. And this window comes up, and it shows you you need to choose a departure location, then your destination. So go ahead and click on select for the departure location. Now this window comes up, and you can choose by putting in the airport name, the airport ID. If you don't know any of those, just come down below and hit the state. Hit the drop down arrow and all your states will come up. We'll go ahead and pick Missouri, and then over here to the bottom left you have your cities, and just go ahead and click on your city, and we'll start this one from St. Joe, Missouri, St. Joseph. And you can see these are the three airports in St. Joe, Missouri. We're going to click on Rosecrans Memorial, and that would be KSTJ. Just left click it. And down here where it says choose a runway starting position, you will start out at an active runway, or you can start out at any runway you want. You can go to a fuel box or a ramp. A lot of your bigger airports have gates. You can pick a gate just wherever you want to go to. We'll start at the parking ramp 10 and click OK. Now you'll go ahead and choose your destination airport. So hit select, and then we're going to stay in Missouri, but we're going to we'll take this to Kansas City, and you can see those are the airports in the Kansas City area. We'll go ahead and pick on KCI, Kansas City International, or KMCI, the call name. So go ahead and click on it and hit OK. Now if you're going to be doing a VFR flight where it's going to be direct GPS, what you'll need to do is make sure that that's checked Make sure that's checked over here. If you're going to fly using an ILS landing, then you'll want to make sure you have the dot put in the IFR spot. We'll leave it right here for VFR and then click Find Route, and your map will come up and it'll be showing from top to bottom a direct flight from St. Joe to Kansas City. Now if you want to take a different route, all you have to do, put your mouse right on that line, left click and hold it, and then just take it to another area, and it's showing you over here where that intersection is. Just go ahead and left click it, and if you want to make another one, just drag it, let it go, and now you have two turns before you get to KCI. Go ahead and hit your nav log, and what this does is brings up your starting position at St. Joe to your first waypoint, gives you your heading, the distance of 11.2 miles. At next waypoint will be 7.5 miles, and then another 17.4 to KMCI. And go ahead and hit OK, and then hit OK again. Now it's going to ask you to save this plan. Go ahead and save it. Now it's going to ask you if you want the simulator to move you to the starting position that you designated, which you will say yes. And your flight plan is now made. If you want to go in and change the fuel payload, you can change it, or you can change the payload of the weight of the passengers. I'll just show you. You can change your pilot weight, co-pilot, to crew, first class, passengers, and then your coach passengers, all the way down to the baggage, and right there to forward baggage and the aft baggage. If you want to change any of that, just put in the weight that you want. Hit OK. Same with fuel. If you want to change the weight and the fuel quantity, just put in whatever you want right here. Go ahead and hit OK. Hit OK again. And to get the current time of what it is today, you will come over here to change the time and season. And as you can see, this is back in July of 2006. And to get it to the current time, just hit reset. And you now are at the exact time that you clicked reset, the month, the year, and the date. Go ahead and hit OK, and you are now ready to hit fly now. If you have any questions, comments, go ahead and leave them. And I hope this has helped answer any questions you might have had. Thanks for watching.